All right, Aki Karim for BBTV. I'm delighted to be joined by Bradley Superski, who makes his ring return this weekend on the Fight Zone shows in Sheffield. Bradley, you must be excited. It's been since 2018 since you've been in the ring, man. Tell me how you feel.
It's been a long time. It's been a long time, but I'm buzzing. I'm buzzing. I'm nearly there now. A few days away, and then can't wait. Going to the bubble tomorrow, and it's going to be all. I'm buzzing. Like I say, I've moved up to Sheffield. I've had a fresh start, new team, and I'm in love with boxing again, and I can't wait to fight now.
Now you must be excited, but also, is there a little bit of nerves creeping in as well because it's been so long out of the ring?
Not really. More excitement than nerves. There'll probably be a bit of nerves on the night, like always. Do you know what I mean? But I'm just excited to be back. More excited than anything. And just don't want to go in there like too over eager. Do you know what I mean? I just need to relax, take my time, and enjoy it.
Now it's a six rounder, I believe, in your ring return. Dale Arrowsmith, obviously, he's known on the circuit and everything, but obviously people are expecting you to come through this one. But is it a case of just getting the cobwebs off, getting used to that feel again, and then looking ahead to something a little bit more meaningful in terms of titles, et cetera, et cetera?
100%. Listen, I will never disrespect or overlook any of my opponents. This is I've been out of the ring 2.5 years, and this is literally like it is a six rounder. Get me back, blow off the cobwebs, get a good win, and then moving forward onto bigger and better things. Do you know what I mean? And I'd like to get out again, and I've maybe an eight rounder, maybe and a step up with a decent opponent, and then going forward, like I'm nerding. Do you know what I mean? I'm title level, Joe. I've been there and done it, and there's no reason I can't do it again. I'm moving up weight. I'm going about 154, so I've done it at 147. I'm sure I can mix it at 154, and that's listen, domestically, there's some great fights there to be made, and I want to be in the mix and get amongst it.
I'm going to ask you the obvious boxing question. You're probably going to expect this one anyway. 154 pounds. Like, do you feel like having that extra bit of fuel in there? Having that bit of extra, wiggle room in the weight cut, do you feel like that's going to make a difference for you, your ring performance?
I feel more comfortable at 154. I was at 147 a long time, and listen, I live well and I live clean, and it was tough to make. I'm not going to sit and say it wasn't, but I'm very big for the weight. But I've done it well. Do you know what I mean? But having that extra 7 pounds is a lot of weight to have. Do you know what I mean? And I think I'm big for 154 as well. So I think I'm going to be a bit better at this weight, a bit more comfortable.
Sorry to cut you off there. I mean, in the build up to this as well, you've been a little bit almost like, you've had something to prove, I feel like, against people who have doubted you, and you've had that bit between your teeth, I feel like. Anyway, what do you think we're going to need to see in the ring from you, performance wise, for people to sort of sit up and take notice of you?
That was definitely, do you know what I mean? I've been out a long time, and my last couple of performances hasn't been great. Obviously getting stopped and whatnot, but I just fell out of love with boxing, and just wasn't in me in there. Do you know what I mean? It wasn't me performing. And so having a big long layoff, people are going to be looking in, and I'm no doubt there's going to be doubters there. But I've got to go in now. And like I say, I've made a big sacrifice to move away from home and like my friends and family, and literally move up to Sheffield and eat, sleep and train. That's all I do up here. And if I didn't mean business, I wouldn't. Oh, and I didn't want to get to the. I mean business, and I want to perform and get to the top. So that's the sort of performance I need to be pulling out. I can't be. Do you know what I mean? This fight, do you know, it's a six rounder, but it's not a level one position that I'm going to be gauging, do you know, myself on. I've just got to go in there, get a good win, look good, and just move on and just each step bigger and better fights.
You're training out of the iconic Winkerbank gym. Dominic Ingle, of course, has had many, many a class fighter. Is he happy with your progress as well going into this fight?
Yeah, definitely. Do you know what I mean? He's I've been up here 8 months now, and it's been a slow process, but it's been a good one. Do you know what I mean? It's not been rushed. It ain't been nothing. It's been like I've just settled in well. I've settled in nice, and this fight's come at a really good time because I was getting that edge. Do you know what I mean? You know when you're just getting that edge to fight, and I'm there now. Do you know what I mean? And Dom's happy. He's happy. I've had some good sparring. I'm ready to go. Do you know what I mean? I'm ready to go.
Ready to go, man. And of course, this fight zone is giving a lot of people a chance. You know, I'm sure you could have got a chance anyway, but you know, it's on your doorstep in Sheffield. There, it's quite a good. Yeah. Platform. Have you been watching the Fight Zone shows, and are you interested in this platform?
Yeah, I've subscribed to the app, and I've been watching the shows, and the production and the setup and everything is unbelievable. It's really good. The fights are real good fights, and the setup's good. And yeah, I'm buzzing to be part of it. And then I'd like to thank Dennis Hobson for giving me this opportunity. Do you know what I mean? I'm not one of his fighters. I'm not with him, and he's done it. He's done it like a favour. He's given me an opportunity to get out and show I'm back and I mean business and get an opportunity on his show. I'm really thankful for.
All right, man. Well, look, I'm looking forward to seeing you myself at the weekend. You're still a big name in the game, so it'd be good to see you get a couple under your belt and then get right back in that mix.
Definitely.
I'll leave the final word to you, Bradley.
Just. If you can't get down, tune in to Fight Zone, get the app and watch my comeback. And it's going to be a good one.
You heard the man. Tune in and watch this guy on Friday on the Fight Zone app. And if you can't tune in, get down and watch him. All right, my man. Appreciate your time. I'll see you on Friday.
See you Friday, bro. Take care. See you soon. Bye-bye. Yeah.